Hello, wonderful, amazing video game type people, and welcome back to Might and Magic 10. Alright. I feel like we're ready to head out, make money, get paid. So I'm actually gonna run around quickly and collect some quests. For a long time, I've been looking for Silver Star ore.
We're here to help!
For Star Silver ore. The sacred metal is rare, as it is only found within fallen stars. Edwin, the astronomer, told me a meteor fell in the desolate wilds a few nights ago. Bring me back the Star Silver, and I'll be able to forge a blade worthy of Ashan's greatest heroes. Cool. Yeah. Can you forge me a blade? I kind of want that. Find the meteor in the desolate wilds. Okay. That's fair. Oh. Oh, that's gross.
Don't like how people are watching me.
Ooh, what is this? What have we found? What? Okay. Cool story, bro. Again, I think this is one of those weird exits where the garbage dump. Ugh, the city garbage dump. Gross. Okay. Anyways, Star Silver ore. Hey! Oh my gosh, such a sad, sad chest. There is a guy here apparently who's a scholar. Nothing. Adventure. I too used to be part of a group of adventurers like yourselves. Good times. I made quite a fortune exploring ancient ruins and, more importantly, surviving their many dangers. I'm retired now, and happily so, but I envy you a little bit. This peninsula is set to harbor many hidden temples and lost cities filled with treasures and gold ripe for the taking. Cool. Thanks, bud. Now, Bear's a nice guy.
Getting late.
Let's take a look at what we want here. Various quests, so maybe the garrison has a quest for me? I'm just gonna quickly check everywhere for quests. No quests. Dun, dun, dun. Hey, does this guy have a quest?
I hear something.
Welcome to Sea Haven, Raiders. Stay out of trouble. Oh, thanks. Oh. Somebody in the... Oh, hello, Galen. Nope, nothing. You're just here to gossip. Get out of here. I don't have time for you. The Mundo! Rumald. Nope, sorry. Well, it's true. I was still a young boy last time we met, back in Hammerfall. I'm Rumald. You do vaguely remember Street Urchin with that name, but that was a long time ago, and you have a nagging suspicion he actually owes you money. Say, you're not hiring by any chance. What? I won't be really useful in a fight, but I can help you get better prices from merchants. All I'm asking in exchange is 700 gold and 2% of the gold we find on our travels. It's a bargain! I'll think about it, Rumald. So, let me get this straight. If I hire him, he gets me, I think it was like 15%. Who wants to play dice? Nobody? Okay, so he's not bad. He could help us get a 15% discount on the... Oh, look! On the other thing. On the silk swords. So if he helps us get a discount on the silk swords, then we'll be good. Oh, you can coach me to Sorpegil, can you? Oh, what happens if I click on that? The coach is about to leave for Sorpegil. You can hop in. The fee is 166 gold. What do you say? No. No. It's nice that we can do that now. But anywho, no. Oh, who's this? Raiders, you're little more than rogues that should be banned from our pristine empire, but maybe you have some usefulness. Heart has its reasons. 2 years ago, Lord Heart, one of the greatest knights of the empire, moved to Sea Haven. I have long suspected Heart is hiding something. Something in his behavior has always been suspicious, such as his frequent trips to the forests of Blackbow. Lord Heart is hiding a dark secret, I'm sure of it, but he knows I'm on his trail. He's covering his tracks. However, he doesn't know you, so you can spy on him and try to discover what he's hiding. Quit. Back. I don't understand. What does quit mean? What does quit mean? I don't want to discover what he's... I don't understand. Spy on Lord Heart. Oh, okay. Cool. Lord Heart's mansion is just over there. You have a quest for me. The Forbidden Saga. Have you visited our library yet? Over the last decade, my daughter Luce and I have been working hard to locate and collect many rare and ancient books. Even if my faith in Elrath is unshakable, I regret the fact that some of my fellow priests seem more interested in spreading obscurantism rather than promoting enlightenment. But I digress. I have spent the last few years trying to find a certain series of epic poems. The Inquisition declared these texts heretic and subversive, for they displayed something that has deemed was due too dangerous at the time. Imagination. The last known copy of the saga is somewhere in the peninsula, but it has been split into 9 volumes. Some of these tomes have been lost, some have been stolen, some are gathering dust on old bookshelves. I want to find them all to preserve them. If you find any of the 9 poems during your travels, bring them to me. You shall be rewarded for your efforts. Cool, thanks, bud. What do you do, Alicia? Once per day, I can channel Elrath's light to heal your wounded and bring your dead back to life. I will accompany you in exchange for a donation of 100 gold. I also expect you to give 3% of all the gold we find to charities. Ugh, awful. Awful, awful, awful. Once per day. That's not awful, but... yeah. It's that percent of gold thing that I really can't get behind. I know it's not a lot, but goodness gracious, there's not enough gold in this game for me to be giving percents out like that. What do you have for me? Nothing. Be gone, Luce. Be gone, Luce. What a weird name. Alright, we've picked up a couple quests. Oh, this guy. Nope.
Don't you have anything better to do than...
Were there any quests up in the Naga Bank area? The Naga regions? I don't think the Naga Bank guy had any quests for me. Be-de-be-ba-ba. Nope, nothing. Maybe I should have done this earlier. Oh well. My apologies. I was just really set on focusing on leveling up, and I don't know. Yeah, okay, nothing. Nothing. Ain't no thing. The dwarves would be the last, I think. But there's still some guy that I'm missing a guy. There's a scholar I'm supposed to... Oh, maybe he's in here. That would actually make a lot of sense to me. Oh, hello. Ooh. Tell me what you have. Oh, hello. Plus fire damage. Ah. Oh, I see. Yeah, that's the benefit of having both of those, is that you can then get something like that, and you get double the bonus. Oh, yeah. Woo! Darkness Warding Ring of Insomnia. Ooh, that is a lot. Oh, my goodness. Why is everything so damn expensive? That's insane. What do we have down here? Yeah, just whispering. Wow, yeah. I mean, I guess that's warrior difficulty for you. It's nice to... He's holy cow. The negotiator might not even be that awful, because 15% off of even, you know, even 1,000 is 150 gold. So over the course of the game, that would actually make a decent difference. Apprentice Staff of Health. No, I mean, you know, I kind of like both of these. Plus 5 fire damage, so that would boost the amount of damage that she could then do. This one would boost her health, though. It's kind of nice. I'm sort of okay with going for the fire damage one. Yeah, just because plus 2 to 2 damage, so a little bit more damage, more crit, and that plus 5 fire damage will bring it up to, you know, what I would call a small, decent amount of damage. Alright, let's do that. It's not like we're getting anything better anytime soon. I guess that means we can... There we go. Go ahead and sell that. Thank you. Mm-hmm. And what is this? Permanently increases vitality by 1 when consumed. Would we like to increase her vitality? Well, probably, truth be told. It's more beneficial on the dwarf, but I don't mind. There we go.
Did you see that?
Another one! We must have surely gotten all these sad little chests by now. There's a dog. Hey! Who's this? Stenar. Ahoy, I'm Stenar Crafty Ragnvaldsson of the Stronghammer Clan. How can I help you? Well, you can't, apparently, so screw you. Okay. Still no scholar quest. I'm beginning to get worried. There's a guy who's supposed to help me. He's a scholar. This wasn't it. Nope. Nothing here. He doesn't give heavy armor, which is kind of a massive bummer. Did one of these guys have a quest for me? Nope. It's good to know we've got the Spearmaster there, though. We're gonna get that soon. Hey, how about this guy? Oh, no, he's just hanging out. Okay, and that guy was just fire magic, I think, up here. Good. Gotta figure out where to go, though. I feel like we've mostly got Sea Haven explored. Where would the scholar be, though? There's gotta be a scholar up in here somewhere. Oh, you know what? I've entirely neglected the north. What about her? I haven't talked to her yet. Danae. Pleasant day. How can I help you? There's the Naga. Right, okay, we're just gonna go all the way up to the... There's a castle of some sort. This is Lord Hart's Manor. Okay, we can see about spying on him at some later point in time. What's up here? The Windsword Garrison. So this must be where the mercenaries would come. Welcome to the Windsword Garrison of Sea Haven. Did you come to hire us or to enlist? Apparently for none of them, Miranda. Do you have something for me? A barrel. Oh, I don't know what's happening. I'm dying over here. I wonder what white is. Air magic, yes! Of course. Okay. Whew. Still not quite sure where I need to go to find that damn scholar. He was even mentioned by somebody else. Hey, here's a person. Have I spoken with this guy? Oh, he's the coach guy.
I know.
I can't shake the feel. Okay, that was Bear. Right? Am I right about that? Was there anyone else up in here? I gotta check. No, that's just Bear. Okay. Because I can't shake the feeling that the guy I'm looking for is in a house here somewhere, you know? Maybe I was wrong. No, certainly not in here. We've checked. The real threat.
I saw it with my own eyes. Better to do than to chat up women.
We've checked the Mundo. The Mundo! It sounds like the Moon Door. Throw him out the Moon Door! Okay. We've checked the Genie. I'm running out of ideas for where to check, so I'm just gonna Google it. Woo! Mm-hmm. Oops. No. Stop. I'm failing at Googling. I don't know how to technology.
You're not complaining, are you?
NPC for hire. Aha! Here we go. The NPC that I'm looking for, specifically, is, what is he? He's a quest NPC.
Hey.
And I believe he boosts. Yeah, Sea Haven, Astronomer's Lab, 4-9. 4-9. Where is the Astronomer's Lab then if it's 4-9? Is that not here? What am I not seeing? 4-9. Okay. So we're almost there. It's in, what is it? This is the one space we missed? Is that what's happening? Oh, don't be. Did we not go in here? We didn't go in here. Oh my goodness. Silly me. My humble apologies. Yes, what do you want? Did you come to ridicule my work like all the others? Edwin, that's a great name. Haha, Baldur's Gate. Okay. Let's face it, I'll probably be long dead before the next eclipse occurs. I therefore cannot rely on eclipses to make my observations. I have to find alternatives. Maybe observing the stars from a high vantage point would reduce the effect of the veil. A suitable place would be the old watchtower in the Menthil Mountains on the western coast of the peninsula. There's only one problem. These mountains are full of feral orcs, goblins, and other barbaric creatures. In other words, I need warriors to escort me. What do you say? Yeah, brilliant. Give me a few moments to gather my instruments.
No slaves.
And I'll be ready to go.
But not for free.
Great, great, great. So he's free, and he increases the experience you gain from defeating enemies by 10%. Thanks, Edwin. Hopefully he never leaves us. Watch him leave us right away. Okay. I'm feeling good. That negotiator fella.
With my own eyes.
Don't you have anything better to do?
He seems useful. All right, let's get out of here. Come on. Off we go. Enter the Agin Peninsula. So the negotiator fellow. I suppose once we've made a bunch of money and we're ready to spend some of that money on items, then we can pick him up. So that in the meanwhile, while we're adventuring, we don't have to pay him for that 2%. And I guess we can get him. Does he shift sale prices as well? I wonder.
With weather like this, I should have taken the day off.
Whoa! I found bad guys. They're right out here.
There are enemies ahead.
I wonder how easily we can kill these guys. Oh my. Militia captain. Okay, apparently not as easily as I would have hoped. Yeah! Bring it on. Are you in combat range? Yeah, you are. Hey. Ooh, nice. Very nice. What did you just do? Battle Spirit. The melee and ranged damage are increased by 20%. Okay. So this is a totally new opponent. Yeah, we're going to use that. And then we're going to cleave you apart, friend. How come so much damage was done by Skelgar? What was Skelgar's attack all about? But genuinely, what was that? Why did you do so much? Oh, because it does air damage as well. Got it. Okay, we're gonna use you again. Oh yeah. I'm liking what we're doing here. Elite Brigand. Okay, let's. We have a bunch of other abilities now, don't we? Purge, sleep, drain life. I'd love to try drain life. Let's do that. Maybe it's too soon for that. What do elite brigands say that they do for us? They have air resistance, so that'll be fine. We can totally drain their life. Nice damage, too. Woohoo!
And stay down!
Not heavy on the armor at all. Alright, the militia captain I'm not particularly worried about.
They're flanking us!
Oh, we're getting surrounded pretty hardcore. Okay. Let's see if we can't take out the militia captain, actually. Or, no, you know what? These guys can go down faster. So let's do that. Go ahead and drain life. Let's see what that does. Woo! I like it! That was very nice. You weren't supposed to block. That's not okay. that affect anyone else? No, I assume that affects people on their square. So, not uber worried about that. Go ahead and drain more life. Hey! That was nice. Did we just get a block out of you? That was nice.
Watch out! Behind us!
Grax is stunned. Yeah, screw you, bud. Dispel the stun. No, that's a fair point. We don't need to. We can just regen.
Thank you for that.
We'll wait until he unstuns. I'm in no rush at all. Grax is no longer stunned.
And stay down! Goblin craft better than this.
Are you serious? We just left the town. You're kidding me right now. Come on. I paid money for that. Like, good money. How much? What is this? What is up with this man's damage resistances? Holy Hannah. Somebody shatter him. Yeah, there we go. It's a good thing he doesn't really resist the, damage from that. Otherwise, he's a little bit heavily armored for my liking. My goodness. You've got to be kidding me. Oh, you've got to be kidding me. Come on. Ah. Stupid. We leave town for 1 second, and next thing you know, you got to run back. Get everything repaired. That's fine. Whatever. At least it was right outside town. Eek. So apparently later on there's an NPC later on that can fix these problems. Meaning it's a hireling. There's a hireling that regenerates the or that repairs weapons on the road. And I feel like I might just end up getting that hireling based on how much crap has broken. Oops, wrong side. It just doesn't look like you can walk down here. Come on now. Silver blades. Silver blades. Sounds like a song. Repair weapons. Yeah, the weapon I just bought from you. That one. You jerk. I hate you so much. Alright, let's see. What do we got? I guess we can just stock up on this, get the negotiator, and then make a little bit more money. And especially if we end up getting a bunch of nice items. Frost and seismic. Yeah, they're still there. So disappointed in you right now, you stupid, stupid elf. Actually, there's something about a meteor. If we can check out the, it sounds to me like if I can get that meteor, she'll reward us with a really nice sword. And I'm hoping, against all odds, that it's not a two-handed sword. That would be lovely, you know? Out we go. Oh, shoot, we didn't get any supplies. Boy, I make poor life choices. Okay. That's fine. Could have gone to the inn, bought some supplies, then gone out ready to fight. Nope. We're going to do things like this today. Come on now.
I hope some brigands attack. Crushing skulls help Octa sleep.
Alright, here we go. We're on the path now. Alright. There we go. Okay, so these are the areas that you need that blessing, which we coincidentally have, so that's nice. I'm definitely...
Oh!
Hello! That's scary. You're scary. Don't scare me. Poisoning strikes and weakening strikes. Wow, you came out of nowhere, bud. Okay, so this is where I'm going to try that sleep thing. So... Ugh. Maybe I won't, though. One attack, eh? And you missed with it. Oh my word. What happened there, exactly? Manticore attacks Erica. 75 damage, 57 physical plus 18 earth. Wow, resisted damage, 8 physical and 1 earth. Okay, cool. I can handle it. Yeah, now you have to attack there. So, Whoa. What did you do? Oh, that was a critical attack. Skelgar is weakened. I don't like that. We need to put some kind of weakness immunity on Skelgar. How do I cure weakness? Anybody know? What is this? What are you doing? Stop.
Thank you for that.
Goodness gracious. Skullcrack? Yeah, there we go. What was it that I wanted to do? I did actually want to do something. I forget what. Oh yeah, dispel magic. Oh, let's try the sleep thing. Yeah, okay. Hey, he's falling asleep. Ends immediately when the target is attacked. The turn of the target is skipped, though. Yeah, so that's what's nice about it, is everyone attacks, and then I put him to sleep, he can't fight. It's a bit dirty, but only a little bit. I think we can kill him. Just kidding. Holy Shinto. What's going on? Oh, that's weakness. Oh, good. Woo! That was a fight and a half. Didn't we just... Elven Bracelet. Oh! That's kind of cool. But no, we're going to run out of supplies so quickly. Like, I don't know if you all understand how quickly we're going to run out of supplies. What is this wolf thing at the head?
I needed to hit something.
Oh, there they come. They're coming in hard. Elite wolves. Good. Yeah. No, this is pleasant. Look at that. Almost dead. I'll take it. Let's go for Celestial Armor.
I feel strong.
Go ahead and hit there, please. Whoa, that was good. That was like 100 damage right off the bat. Go ahead. Oh, you missed. You weren't supposed to miss.
And stay down.
That was nice. Good job, double block. Bam, baby. A little bit disappointed in my spear wielder here. I understand that it is wolves, so. It's a little bit different. There we go.
And stay down.
That was super easy. Hopefully it's safe for us to keep going this way. Look, I found a nice little house. Tribal amulet. Hey, potions. I like potions. What's here? Ah, the Axe Grandmaster. I am Drengi, Blood Axe Gainson of the Grimsteel Clan. This is my farm. State your business or get out. Surprised to see a dwarf farmer. And what do you think we eat? In Grimheim, we raise goats and sheep. Above ground in the valleys, during the short springs and summers. The herds are brought underground for the long winter, feeding on dried bales of mountain grass. I suppose it's no surprise. My people has a fondness for ewe cheese as well. If you haven't tasted a 3-year-old blue vet fang, you haven't tasted anything. Cool. Something feels really...
Yes.
Awkward.
On Mother Earth, under Father Sky.
With the music. I think we're having a music book. Ah. Music book time. No. We're just gonna fix it by loading the game. Yes. Thank you. Yeah, I felt like there were two tracks playing or something. Something was off there. I didn't like that. But still, that fight was fun. I'm feeling like my guys are pretty tough now. I like seeing blocks coming out of the others as well. Blocks, and they're pretty high evade to begin with, so that's nice. There we go. Stop with the ladder every time. Oh! Hey, hello. Earth elementals? I think they're easy.
This one is mine.
What's he doing? Okay. Oh, he's just stone skinning himself. That's fine. I can purge that in time. Armor value is increased. It's not that big of a deal. Is that? I guess it is, now that I think about it. That's 8% less damage. So, why don't we... Well, let's try it. What happens if I were to use... Was it purge? Okay. So slightly less armor. And then you go in with that. Even less armor now. Good. And he didn't cast the spell again. I'm so down. Did he just do it? He just did it. Nonetheless, I think we can kill this guy. Alright. On this side of things. What does the Earth Elemental not resist? It was down here somewhere, wasn't it? There we go. Oh, we don't know yet. We don't know yet, but they have really crap evasion. Nice. Okay, so I'm thinking same thing. Yeah. Whoa, that was nice damage. Let's see if you can't do the same thing, I guess. Purge. Did he just put it on himself again? Well, at least that was one turn that he didn't attack us, but... Alright, we'll do it this way. We'll purge him first, and then go ballistic on his ass. Yeah, see, it just makes them so much easier to hurt. Why was that a double attack? Grax attacks and misses? Why did we get two attacks with Grax? What? I'm so confused. Why did Grax attack twice?
Well, thank you for that.
I like Purge. I'm really, really starting to like it. There we go. I think we've found Lord Kilburn. There you go. See, that's what happens right there. The Yong Chao Forest. Uh-oh. Hello, fellow travelers. Judging by your attire, I intuit you are raiders from the Free Cities. Did you come here to enjoy the view? Ah, Lord Kilburn, we found you. And he's a Shield Grandmaster. Good for him. Is this the letter?
Yes! More glory!
Is improving.
He looks at it intensely for a few moments. Yes, I recognize his handwriting. A long time ago, when I was just a squire, I briefly served under Lord Montbard, a knight of the Greyhound Duchy and hero of the wars against the elves. He had me deliver quite a few missives so I can ascertain he's the author of those heinous lines. That such a hero has descended into mere banditry is unsettling, to say the least. Incidentally, Montbard was governor of this very peninsula before he was presumed dead during the second eclipse when the demons besieged Port Mehron. Looks like he's actually very much alive. Let's see what else this letter can teach us.
More glory!
Interesting. A distinctive scent, moisture, limestone, and mushrooms? Suddenly, he springs on his feet like a man possessed and unfolds a large map of the peninsula on the nearby table. The map is covered with scribbles and arrows. Look, I've been keeping track of the brigands' attacks. I have come to the conclusion that the scoundrels have a hideout within the Yon Chao Forest. But maybe it is not in the forest, but below. There are many stories of ancient underground tunnels in this region. This is where you'll find Montbard, I'm sure of it.
Finally, the raiders had a name.
We're
the
here
mastermind
to help.
Behind the brigands' attacks. Montbard, a former knight of the Empire. A man everyone believed dead in the wake of the second eclipse. A man now determined to set the whole peninsula on fire. The raiders did not wait for John Morgan's approval to go after Montbard. They knew what they had to do. They would find the fallen knight and put an end to him.
Cool, we can do that. Peninsula Incognita. Yeah. I'll do that later. Yeah! Everyone got 500 experience and almost 2,000 gold. That's awesome. Alright, so we're gonna...
When I find myself in a forest like this, I'm almost in a good mood. Almost.
I'm kind of miffed at the music again. The battle music hasn't subsided.
We are all aware that
even
these
though I'm pretty sure it's
full
supposed
of brigands,
to subside.
Right?
So we're gonna control F. We're gonna load that quick save. I can't handle that music. I'm sorry. Maybe it's just this area. It's kind of unfortunate. I guess I could turn down the music. Turn it off completely. At least just while we're adventuring in these parts. Alright, I like this. We can level up and get some skills. Maybe I'll do that and then cut the episode. So we found Lord Kilburn, so that was nice. Yeah, absolutely. Let's master that shield, baby. For that retaliation strike. Boom. Sold. With our friend here, we're going to master the spear. Absolutely, we're going to master the spear. And I guess once we've mastered the spear, we could go towards Grandmaster. We could try to master two-hand. Or we could continue with along the dodge path. I'm not really sure. Endurance wouldn't be awful. Medium armor. Ah, I see. None of these actually seem that awful. Mysticism, admittedly, wouldn't be awful for getting some of that extra mana. I truthfully don't know. Endurance? Let's try to get endurance up. That's going to be helpful. I would say, for sure. For sure that'll be helpful, yeah. Maybe we should continue boosting his spear, though. Over here, we're just going straight for Grandmaster, I believe. Yeah, look at that. One more level. Boom. And with our dear friend here, I actually have no idea what to go for. Mysticism doesn't sound awful. Dark magic mastery. No, I genuinely have no idea, so mysticism it will be. Yeah, and she's starting to get quite a bit of mana, so that's going to be helpful. Okay. Our dear dwarven friend here. We don't want him to miss too much, but I do want him to start getting a little bit more into critting. So something like that should be fine. On this side of things. Again. Want to just boost up the crit chance. So we'll go one in perception. Because we also have to keep these values, these three values high so that we can get into those special areas. Okay. Oh, baby. Look at that. Beautiful crit chance. Higher hit chance, maybe? Something like that. That's not a bad way to play. Okay. How are we doing? Yeah, we're doing pretty good. 15% crit chance. 7% crit chance. I'll take it. You know? Maybe something we get later lets us boost that even further. Yeah, I kind of want to go into magic harder. So yeah, just boost that up. Maybe all four this time. Vitality is not awful. Okay, we'll go all four this time on magic. And see if that's actually made a difference at all. Maybe not. Maybe it has. Okay, so we need to get shield mastery, which I believe that was at Castleport Mehron. And spear mastery, which was the dwarf. Yeah, okay. That's 3,000 gold. Ugh, so much money. Still, that's exciting. What is that? Have we found an obelisk? Oops. Oop. I'm scared. I don't want to fight someone right now. I'm busy. I'm trying to get spear mastery. And that's actually so exciting. It ignores 50% of the armor. That's really exciting. Okay. Alright, so he's going to start finally just creaming heavily armored opponents. If we ignore 50%, right? So that would... And I mean, that you start to see that it gets pretty big, right? Some of those heavily armored guys, they'll have, say, you know, enough armor that they're cutting out 50% of the damage going against them. But then, if we do our thing, then instead of cutting that all out, it'll only be a quarter, because it would half the armor I take it. Spearmaster. Valkyrs, if you favor spears and already have some knowledge of how to wield them, I can train you further. You are now a master of the spear. There's only one man in this region who knows more about spears than I do. Iason, the Praetorian captain of Karthal. Alright, so that's not happening for a while. Nonetheless, that is very exciting. Master Spear. Your strikes with spears ignore 50% of the target's armor value. Yep, that's beautiful. Okay, and now to Port Mehron for the shield mastery. So much for money, hey? Nonetheless, that's useful. And I'm pretty excited about that, the idea that we get a free strike with our dwarf. So it would be nice to boost his perception a little bit, I think. Maybe even his vitality. It's hard because you kind of want to put points in everything, you know? You can't go without putting points in vitality, really, because it just otherwise you just don't have enough health. That's really just how it is. But, yeah. Crazy. We're going to have some lag as we switch areas here. Right there. There you go. That's your... Oh! Ashen Hills.
I'm happy to see you again, my friends. What?
Oh, the hunt for Mount Bard. Training Swordmaster. Training Shieldmaster. Okay. You are now Master of the Shield. If you want to learn more, look for Lord Kilburn, the Sun Crusader. Oh, we've already found him. So we can get Grandmaster of Shield. Oh, that's so true. That's amazing how suddenly Shield just, boom, you get it all. I wonder if it'll be worthwhile
getting
that.
What news do you bring?
The hunt for Mount Bard.
Find him. Stop it. But be discreet about it. If the mastermind of these attacks is really a former knight of the Empire, I can't imagine the diplomatic consequences. I'm happy to see you again, my friends.
Thanks,
John. This will be easy.
Nope. Yeah, this will be easy. Of course it will. Okay. I'm actually kind of curious about that now. Would it be worthwhile? You try to block ranged strikes against other party members that have no block attempts left, as long as you have general block attempts. Okay, pretty much everyone else will have no block attempts. So, Grandmaster tier bonus. I don't know. Well, look at that. That's amazing. We've come a long way. Retaliation strike. So that's going to come in handy. That's going to happen quite often, I imagine. Okay. So we're going to head back across. You know what? Since we're here, let's buy some supplies. You know? Oh. There we go. Body supplies. Thank you. The party now owns 9 supplies. Nice. What is it? Oh, no, we've already dealt with that. Okay, so what I want to do now is... Yeah, we've been kind of ignoring that area, but... Okay, so a couple things. For example, there's probably another crypt across in that area, so I'd love to find that crypt, solve whatever puzzle it has, and then get the relic.
Who's with me?
I imagine the sooner I get the relic, the better. Okay, yeah, we can rest. There we go. Yeah, so that's kind of what I want to do. Also, did we want to just keep going with spear mastery or spear attacking to increase that damage further? I don't remember what the grand decision here was. Mysticism, endurance. Oh yeah, I guess let's just get to expert endurance. That'll give us a little boost. Dodge maybe. Retaliate with one melee attack. That would be really cool. Grandmaster dodge, but that won't happen for a while, I'm sure. So maybe we'll just boost endurance. Okay, yeah, so that's the war plan. Is finding that. Hopefully not finding that. If we go to our quests here. What I want to do is... Yeah, no, I don't want to do that. I want to do... Fallen Star. That's the one I want to do. Find the meteor in the desolate wilds. A meteor has fallen. So that's basically it. Cool. I will be able to forge powerful weapons. Some Star Silver ore. Yeah, and then maybe she'll give me as a reward a really nice sword. So that would be nice. I want to do that. Okay. Thanks so much for watching, folks. I will see you next time when we go and we fight a bunch and try to find that sword. Okay. Bye.